We developed this practice that would help them do it, and we're pretty excited about it. I describe it in detail in the book. It's what we call the Awareness Positioning System, or the APS. So now, the best way to understand the APS is to think of your GPS, your Global Positioning System. It's like, think of it like a GPS for transformation, or for a life practice, or for a way to become fulfilled. All right, now, so for this APS, what you imagine then is like a plus sign or a cross. And so you have two vectors. You've got the vertical and the horizontal. Now, on the horizontal is all of the experiences that we human beings have that are outside ourselves. So in this case, it'd be like the experience of the movie is outside ourselves. Now, the vertical nature is everything that's happening within us. So below then this place where these two intersect is all of our personal issues, our past, the things that we have forgotten about that are motivating us to be the way we are today. And then also mystics would say that it has to do with even with our birth process and so on. Now, above this intersection here are all of our experiences with what we might call moving toward wholeness, our higher self. Some people call it the divine, but you don't have to call it that. It's basically just any experience that moves us toward wholeness. Okay, so now here's how this cross works. Here's how the APS works. When you're watching a movie and you have an experience, whatever it is, anger, fear, love, joy, whatever it is, then you bring your awareness positioning system online. You think about it. And so then what you imagine is the experience you're having is on the horizontal arm of the cross. And then you bring that then back to yourself, right here to the central part. If you could imagine my arms being spread, and this would be, it would come back to the heart then. And so you take the emotion there, and then you ask yourself that question, as I said, is this feeling familiar, or have I ever felt this before? And then what you do is you go vertical with it. You take it within yourself, and you look down in yourself. And so this way, what we're actually doing is self-empowerment. It's about owning responsibility for our own lives, and we are no longer victims by what happens outside ourselves. We're not a victim of the movie. The movie is showing us something. Every experience that we have in a movie, no matter what it is, has a little bit of a trademark on it that's saying, opportunity to heal, opportunity to heal. And it's our responsibility to wake up. I mean, we could feel victimized by the movie if we wanted to, but that would just be us being a slave. I mean, I believe that one of the beautiful things about life is to become more empowered. And so to take responsibility and to not feel victimized by something outside ourselves would be wonderful. And this way, we're not victims of the movie, but the movies are opportunities for us to heal. So now this is just one practice that we use. The lovely thing is movie yoga turns out to be just one form of a life yoga, because this strategy, this APS strategy, works for relationships, it works for people, for friendships. It works for every experience that you have in your life. Most of us go through lives feeling that we are victims or that our happiness depends on what happens outside ourselves. And if we feel that way, we will always be disappointed, because you've got 6 billion people all over the world. And everybody's trying to do the same thing, make themselves happy by something outside ourselves. But with the APS, you realize that the outside experience is an opportunity for us to change inside ourselves, to be guided then by some deep inner healing wisdom, which every human being has. And this then is the true source of our happiness.